This video is the last one in a sequence following on from flasking and the packing processing videos. This is where the hard set acrylic resin is removed from the two-part mould called deflasking, and the final trimming and polishing of the dentures called finishing. This will produce acrylic dentures ready for the clinical final insertion stage.
After processing, the denture flasks are cooled down with cold running water. Once they're sufficiently cooled, the clamp can be opened and the dentures removed. We can remove the hard plaster from the mould using a rawhide hammer, hitting the metal button on the inside of the flask. The same hammer can be used to separate the stone from the flask once opened. In this instance, we use a half-round chisel to remove the stone from around the fitting surface of the acrylic denture. We can remove the stone from other parts of the denture using plaster snips, although great care must be taken to ensure that the denture does not crack. With careful precision, we continue to snip away at the plaster bit by bit in a direction away from the denture. We continue to do this until all traces of stone and plaster have been removed from the acrylic. To assist in the removal of any fine debris from around the surfaces and spaces, we place the dentures into an ultrasonic bath contained within a plastic beaker filled with a chemical plaster remover. The ultrasonic bath should run for about 10 minutes. After 10 minutes in the ultrasonic bath, the dentures can be removed and dried. We now trim off the excess acrylic using a variety of different abrasives, starting with a tungsten carbide burr. First of all, we remove the excess that has been pushed out between the two halves of the flask. We call this the flash. Once the flash has been fully removed, we cycle through the various grades of burr to smooth and contour the surface of the denture, taking time to round off the sulcus edges. It's essential that we identify and notch the points of muscle attachment in order to attain a good fit. We tend not to touch the fitting surface where possible, but if you can feel any sharp edges to it, then they can be removed with the very gentle use of a stainless steel rosehead burr. Once the rougher edges have been removed, we can smooth it still further using a silicone polisher. This is the equivalent of using sandpaper. Having trimmed the lower denture, we now turn our attention to the upper. In this case, we need to trim the post-dam area to the correct dimensions. A metal burr is used to come in towards the raised edge that has been created, and once again, the variety of burrs can be used to achieve the correct finish. Moving over to the polishing lathe, it's time to apply the final finish to both dentures. The first material that we'll use consists of pumice in the form of thick slurry. We'll use a familiar approach here, employing a variety of brushes ranging from coarse to smooth. We apply pumice to the denture, and by spreading fingers beneath it, we can support it under pressure to ensure that it doesn't break. Moving it around will work the pumice into the denture and remove any light scratches and bumps. This polishing should be applied only to the main flange areas and sulcus edges. Once a good matte finish has been created, we now have to polish to achieve the denture's required glossy appearance. We can achieve this using a cotton mop and a block of denture polishing wax. Again, it's essential to support the denture by spreading our fingers while applying pressure. When the process is complete, we should have perfectly finished dentures with a high gloss on both the sulcus edges and the contoured surface.